coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We're going to be covering the latest event that will be used like Trayvon Martin to promote racial division in this country. And to make that the only issue, not the globalists that are literally deindustrializing the country and artificially creating a climate of poverty as a tool of social control. We will get into that today, but there is so many other important stories that we've got to get to. And yes, now Trayvon Martin's family attorney is to represent the slain Missouri teen. And Infowars.com has discovered tweeted photos taken by citizens in Ferguson, Missouri, of looters wearing Remember Trayvon Martin, Rest in Peace Trayvon Martin shirts. So the answer when the police questionably shoot an unarmed black teen is not to burn down grocery stores and convenience stores and people's houses and to burn up cars in your own neighborhood. The answer would be to get politically involved and go after the police department if they've been proven wrong. But doing stuff like this will only make the relations between the police and the black community that much worse. And this is just a little forte, a little hors d'oeuvre in the future of this nation, especially when the media like MSNBC and the White House only have race baiting and racial politics as their issues, because they're not delivering on any other front. They're not delivering jobs. They're not even delivering bigger welfare checks. They're just delivering collapse. And their own people that have gotten basically raised on welfare across the political spectrum are getting antsy, are getting restless. And the answer is, let's just have a war with the police, which is only going to then have the police be driven into the arms of the feds, who are really globalists and have been occupied by the New World Order. They will then federalize the police, create federal command centers, militarize them, and then they will bait and switch and use the paramilitary police on gun owners, returning veterans, Christians, conservatives, libertarians. There's another photo in Paul Watson's article confirmed by local news to be Bradley fighting vehicles rolling out to be refitted for Homeland Security. People saw them rolling through the town last night as things were burning and were cheering the National Guard's here. Obama has sent them because they've been federalized. No, the governor didn't send them. The president didn't send them. The Bradley fighting vehicles are being sent for Homeland Security and NORTHCOM for the American people and gun owners. And Obama told the New York Times over the weekend, in an article published in the New York Times, he did the interview a week ago, and they were reportedly going to put video out later in the interview as well, but it's text right now, that the number one threat to America is conservatives and extremist ideology that has, quote, taken over the GOP. Well, it is true. The libertarian, reality-based survival movement is taking over the GOP because the GOP leadership has sold out to the globalists, and so we're kicking these people out. Not just Eric Cantor, the march is on. And so this is the threat. The Tea Party is the threat to the globalists. Not that it's perfect, but it is real opposition. Doesn't want to bankrupt the country, doesn't want to take the guns, doesn't want to open the borders, doesn't want to fund Al-Qaeda. And so, they are coming after the American people. That's a Breitbart article. It's not Infowars.com or PrisonPlanet.com. I'm glad that Breitbart It's finally reporting on when the New York Times reports that they're preparing for war with people that don't engage in burning down buildings.
This is Scottish John for Infowars.com. I know that most of you here in this commercial already know about the New World Order, eugenics, and all the other issues covered here at Infowars. The question is, do your friends and family know? If not, then I want to know why. Oh, I know it's tough to talk about this with some people. They might call you names, or they just want to talk about sports or soap operas. I say, so what? There's a battle going on out there right now. The ammunition is information, and the soldiers are you. It's time to transform your game from passive listener to active participant. We from Scotland have had our skin in this game for the greater part of the last 1,000 years, and I'm still fighting. If we don't all stand up right now, we're going to lose everything. The InfoWar is worldwide. Tell your friends about InfoWars and let them know that InfoWars doesn't print bull. It's real journalism and news backed up by documented fact. Step up and take your friends and family to InfoWars.com, PrisonPlanet.tv and PlanetInfoWars.com. The truth will set them free.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
In the near future.
When you realize how fake it all is, the football, the basketball.
Alert. Security alert. This is Homeland Security. Analysis. InfoWars building independent media operations.
We let the worst people get controlled and tell us that we are the ones responsible.
Prime Directive. Discredit Alex Jones.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist.
A popular conspiracy theory talk show called InfoWars.
Alex Jones is now in an Austin jail.
These people are assaulting us.
Targeting of patriots engaged.
They are never going to stop. They're never going to deviate from their program until we stop them.
Block free iPhone app at InfoWars.com. Block free podcast and video feed. Imperative. Destroy Prison Planet TV.
You gotta set your eye on the enemy, not worry about what propaganda they put out. Intellectually, it's begun and you can feel it.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us on this live Monday edition, the 11th day of August, 2014. And we will be here for the next 3 hours live. Pastor Chuck Baldwin, former presidential candidate for the Constitution Party and a leading patriot out there exposing how our churches have been federalized, how our churches have been seized, will be joining us to talk about the Hitlerian doctrine of Romans 13 and how the churches have been turned into engines of politically correct brainwashing. So he's going to be joining us in the second hour today for 30 minutes. In the last 30 minutes of the third hour, New York TV host, a syndicated radio host, Leinold, who was attacked along with myself and Matt Drudge last week by Keith Olbermann and a bunch of other individuals for daring to question establishment orthodoxy. He's going to be joining us to talk about a whole bunch of important news issues and more today, and we will have open phones as well. In fact, I want to take phone calls for first-time callers today, to discuss Obama's bombing of ISIS and what's really behind that, to get into the escalations in Ukraine, to get into a stack of news of more political correctness that is being deployed as an authoritarian blanket across the nation. Also, IBM has developed a functioning computer chip with 1 million neurons that, again, functions like a human brain. That's out of the Daily Mail. That integrates in with a story out of the Charlotte CBS affiliate. Report, robots will take over more jobs than they create. Yes, that's the big issue. That's how that's being set up and implemented. We're going to talk about some of the technocracy at the bottom of the hour. We're also going to get into the big developments with the rioting in Ferguson that's tied into the Obama race baiting promotions via all the propaganda we've seen on MSNBC and CNN with Trayvon Martin. That is all coming up today here on this syndicated broadcast. I'll give the number out coming up at the start of the next segment. In fact, let me just move here in the stack from right to left today and begin with what's happening with Obama's airstrikes that started last Thursday against IS, Islamic State, formerly ISIS, formerly Al-Qaeda. And there are some whoppers today. Obama says Iraq airstrike effort could be long-term. So the war never ended there. Now it's back on for the foreseeable future. And again, what is behind that? IS was set up for the last 4 years, given billions of dollars in eastern Syria by Turkey, by Israel, by Saudi Arabia, by Qatar, by NATO, by France, by the British, and by the United States. On record, you can just pull up hundreds of articles in the New York Times and even in the Council on Foreign Relations admitting that 60%+ of the fighters were Islamic State. And then our media would be like, well, that's why we need to get behind the nice fighters that only, you know, blow up the churches. They don't, and only cut off the men's heads and rape the women. They don't kill the babies. And then the Al-Qaeda people, they even behead the children of the Christians and of the Sunnis, not the Shia. I mean, the Shia, not the Sunnis. And so they just play on your incredible ignorance and the general public's ignorance. They think that the people that are uninformed just have no idea what's even going on and can't find the Middle East if the countries even had names on them. And so now people ask, well, why is Obama bombing IS? Because they don't completely control it. They just funded it, helped radicalize it, gave it basis. IS is now even attacking Jordan, which helped arm them and train them probably more than any other country when it came to physical bases. Our military was made to tolerate IS bases on the border in the last 3+ years with Syria, with Iraq. Turkey has given artillery support and shelled the military of Syria that has been fighting them for 3+ years. And that's why a bunch of military officers in the Marines, the Army, the Air Force, and the Navy all went public last year when we were going to bomb openly the Syrian capital and Syrian power plants and water treatment and military bases and airports so that Al-Qaeda could take over. It was a big backlash. It stunned the globalists, completely confused them. Bilderberg was beside itself from our sources. This is one of the main topics, how to spin it. And they decided to spin it by rebranding as ISIS, then as IS. They'll probably rename it a couple more times to then confuse everybody and sheep dip Al-Qaeda. And then we pointed out they would then come into Iraq when they started attacking 4 months ago in Fallujah. Our military was not allowed to strike back when their convoys came in by the hundreds of vehicles per convoy. When the artillery was moved in, they were allowed to set up their state so they can't be kicked out. But now they've got to be contained when they try to go into Shiite areas in the east and south and into Kurd areas.